Jenny says, I think that we should just break up. You know, it's not just this. I mean, you're away a lot of the time. And even when you're here, you work at night and I work in the day. I just don't think it's gonna work out. And I said, okay. We were apart for about 6 months and I missed her so much, but I kept resisting calling her because I wanted to give her space. And every once in a while, I'd get a glimmer of hope in the form of a text message from Jen, Irish pub, nice. And it would just say, hi. And I'd write back, hi. It was the smallest form of communication two people could have with one another, but I think in some ways kept us together. And finally on New Year's, I caved in and I called her. I said, hey, I really miss you and I wanna see you. And we got together for coffee and we hit it off just like we used to, and we decided we would get back together. We had a great period there, you know. I took her to get a license and a passport. First we went for her social security card, and then we took that to the DMV, and then we mailed all of that to the government for a passport. It was like the triple crown of identifications. Jenny was wildly identifiable. And one night she was heading back from my apartment to hers and she stops. And I said, what? And she says, I think that we should live together. And I said, No, I really don't think that's a good idea. You know, I've just decided, you know, as a principle, I'm not gonna get married or live with someone. It's not personal. And she said, well, unless we live together, I just don't think it's gonna work out because we just don't see each other enough and I don't think that we stand a chance. That's how I feel. So we moved in together. One day, Jenny gets an invitation to the wedding of one of her friends, and she invites me to come along, and I said, oh, no thanks. That doesn't go over so well. She says, why? And I said, well, as you know, I don't believe in marriage, and so I don't buy into the flamboyant pageantry that goes into celebrating it. She said, well, what do you believe in? I said, I don't know. She said, well, if you don't believe in anything, how can you not believe in marriage? And I said, well, first of all, it just doesn't seem necessary. I mean, marriage is an archaic institution invented in the Middle Ages based on exchanging property. I don't want to be a part of that. Second of all, I don't even think we have a common cultural understanding of what marriage even is. I mean, one of me and Andy's friends was about to get engaged, and we were skeptical, and we said, are you sure this is the person you want to be with for the rest of your life? And he goes, yeah, I think so. And we said, well, what if she gets in a car accident and she's disfigured? Would you stay with her then? And he said, maybe. That is not an acceptable answer!